you're playing. Make sense? Andy, don't play the melody. Okay. Okay, what did we see Claire do with her posture? She lifted her baton. What did we see her do with her posture? Yeah, she hunched in a little bit. Okay? This is the first class I haven't had to do this with since I taught here. Normally, that's what everybody does. I take everybody out in the hallway and I have them stand against the wall. So that would be, yeah, good. So that might be a good way for you to practice for the next couple times. Stand against the wall in front of a mirror and practice that way. Remember what I told you the other day, or I guess it was Thursday. The best way to practice, well, two great ways. One, in front of the mirror while you're recording yourself and back against the wall. And the other best way is practice conducting a person and have them play what you show and record it and watch it. Okay? So nice and tall. Your posture is really important. Good. Palm up. Stop. And you notice that Claire's breathing with her feet. We see this happen as she takes a breath. Just remain grounded in the podium. Okay? And again. And if you're more confident with your breath and your doubt, they'll be more confident in their playing. Looks like you're reading a newspaper. Yeah, oh good, you're very expressive. So you want, even at this early stage, to just start letting go, being vulnerable, because that's what the class is all about. And there's lots of things to respond to, lots of wrong notes, interesting things. Let's do it again. Let's have no more wrong notes this time. And more phrasing, okay? And a little bit faster. Bring out the eighth note line more, please. Thank you. Stop. Start with. Play the first note with me. And again. So what I'm doing, I'm showing them right where that downbeat's going to be, and then I'm playing it with them as I'm sustaining that. Okay, so you can actually do that in real time. Now play the music. Exaggerate the phrasing, and again. Thank you. Exaggerate the phrasing, and again. Notebook, capital letters, impulse of will. You can think of it as willpower. Impulse of will is Elizabeth Green's term. Impulse of will, it took me 3 times to ask for it and to show it for them to actually do it, which is fine, maybe a little sleepy, but whatever, I'm not. So what you have to do as a conductor is want what you want so much that they finally give it to you. Okay, don't hurt them. Inspire them to want to do it, okay? That's the best way to do it, don't hurt them. Okay, here we go. We're going to learn how to write really fast. First step. Having the ensemble exaggerate their playing because of it is the second. You responding to their response to your conducting is the third step. That's the step that develops rapport with your group. That's the step that inspires them to want to continue to exaggerate everything you show. You got the first step. Here we go. It's hard for people to get that first step, so you're doing great. Now, we have to have compulsive will. Stop. Guitar's early. Don't let anybody play early. It has to be on time. Tip down. Tips together. Notebook. Think of the triangle of communication. Eyes are the tip, are the top of the triangle. Tip of the baton is the bottom. Fingertips of the left hand are the bottom. So you've got your triangle of communication, eyes, tips. And what that does, it brings them into your center. Okay? Thank you. Palm up, tip down, tips are together. Stop. There's a lot of, okay? Be grounded. Be centered, be well balanced, put everything to the tip of the baton. Tip down. Showing a couple places diminuendo, you're using this gesture, and maybe you've seen me use it, and I stole it from Christopher Warren Green because I think it works really well. But what you have to do is foreshadow it before you use it. A look of something's about to happen, the foreshadow, and then use it, and then it'll work for you. But very nice first time. Nice job. Thank you. Yay! Next!